Good morning. Welcome to the show. It's 10 o'clock on the August Bank Holiday weekend, and we're joined today not only by Rich and Dan from The Feeling, but by Rich's wife and now collaborator Sophie Ellis-Bextor.
And as well as that, we have a man who is a pop star, an opera star, and certainly has the X Factor, Joe McElderry.
The studio was literally packed with people to do some cooking, try some cocktails, and take a look at next week's telly.
Yeah, this is something for the weekend.
Right, our first three guests have more than a little in common. They all are multi-platinum selling artists. They all produce catchy pop tunes that have dominated the top 10, and they are now back with two brand new albums between them. I thought it was over, but it's not. I'm in love with a fool, and you don't want you lost. We are one. Find us under the starlight, starlight, starlight. What more can I say? Set my world on fire. I don't care. I don't care what you say. I love you more. I love you more every day. I know I shouldn't go, but something makes me crave the heat. Your love is bittersweet. So two of them are married, two are bandmates, one has just cameoed on the other's album. Well, can you work that one out?
Nope.
No. No. Welcome to Soap for the Weekend, The Feeling and Sophie Ellis-Bextor.
Morning.
Hi, guys.
Right. Welcome to the show. So what's going on? You both got albums out at the moment, is
yep.
that right?
Yeah.
Are they going out at the same time? Are you going to be in competition
they
with each
other?
They
come out about a week apart or something like that, 2 weeks
yeah.
apart?
They're both already out.
Yeah, they came out in spring.
All right, but you're singing on their album,
yes,
but
yes.
they don't feature on your album.
No. God, no.
So when did the idea hatch that you were going to sing a song together? Because you play a lot together, don't you?
Yeah, and I mean, Richard and I actually met because Richard was in my band as well for a while, so we have worked together in the past, but I think it must have been from when the song
Yeah, essentially the song happened and we'd always wanted to do something together,
yeah.
Singing-wise, but kind of needed to happen naturally. You know, you can't force these things, and the song just came about, and it just sounded like it was going to be perfect for Sophie's voice. And we asked her, and she liked the song.
It's kind of handy, though, in a way, isn't it? Because I think when you're at home, you're all friends, you all hang out together. Yeah. There are those times we think, well, you know, let's go and write a song, or let's. Oh, I couldn't do that at home. Say to my husband, should we just have a little songwriting session here? I doubt it.
Okay.
I'll go. But it must be quite handy. I mean, is this something you've always done? Do you write together, maybe? The songs that don't make the album, but for other people.
Well, we did a song together for the Sophie's last record.
Exactly, yeah.
I wrote
a couple
songs.
Yeah.
It's still very natural, isn't it?
Yeah.
Because we're all in the same house. I played bass on her last album. They wrote songs together.
Dad lives in your house as well.
Well, we used to live together.
When
Sophie, when we started dating, I was living with Dan.
Right, okay.
So in the early days.
Yeah. And we've all got studios in our houses, so often we're just visiting and, you know, we end up in the studio. It's quite natural.
After a big party.
Yeah.
Exactly. Come, let's go down into the studio.
But you do play these corporate gigs sometimes, these big corporate gigs, and Sophie will come on stage with you, won't she, and play and sing, and you'll do it. So you're used to playing with each other, aren't you?
Yeah.
Not just the corporate stuff, I mean, all the...
It's just if we're, you know, it just makes it interesting. If everyone's there, Paul's wife gets up as well, or Beverly Knight sings with us sometimes, and Glenn Tilbrook from Squeeze is a good friend. So maybe yourself, next time you're out, come up.
I'll be there.
Oh, what about me?
Tambourine.
Tambourine in the corner.
Yeah. I wouldn't give me that much responsibility. Just keep the mic on. Talking about touring, we had Hertz on the other day, and they spend a lot of their time in Eastern Europe, and you do as well, don't you? You're big over there.
Yeah, I did a gig this weekend in a place called Kharkiv, which is in the north of Ukraine, in a town square to 200,000 people. It's crazy. It's just bizarre to sort of go away and find yourself in this. It was Ukrainian Independence Day this week, you see, so, it was extraordinary.
Do you know how you've become so huge in Eastern Europe?
You've had some hits.
Yeah, the last sort of 4 or 5 singles have done quite well there, which has been good. They love like electro and dance music, which is predominantly what my album is. And I guess I just sort of nurtured it a bit, really. I go over there a lot. I'm often in Moscow and I've been to St. Petersburg.
Territories do like it when you actually visit and perform there, don't they? It feels that they appreciate
you. And if you're a singer, you like being invited to come and sing. So, yeah, it's been fun.
Hertz said to me it's more not so much about the record sales, it's about they turn up to the gigs. Is that the same thing? Is a few people buy the records, but hundreds of thousands turn up to the gigs?
There's definitely a bit of that. I mean, I think there's, you know, quite a lot of piracy and that kind of thing in places like Russia, so it's quite hard to tell exactly how many records you're actually selling sometimes. But, you know, I've been to places as far-flung as Vladivostok and a place called Perm and, you know, sort of got quite a good little passport collection of stamps going on now.
Well, last week you played to 200,000. Today you're going to play to about...
A few.
10 in here and millions at home. So you're gonna do a song for us, the one off the album, right?
Yeah. Okay. This is our new duet.
Yes.
It's called Leave Me Out of It, and it goes something like this. Leave me out of it. You're alone and that's your thing. Maybe that's your thing. I don't hear your voice. You're alone and that's your choice. Maybe that's your choice. But you don't know what love is till you've had mine. You don't know what love is till you've had mine. Don't know what love is till you've had mine. Coming through your door soon, I'll have you calling out for more.
You don't know what love is till you've had mine. Don't know what love is till you've had mine. Don't know what love is till you've had mine. Don't know what love is, but you need some. A crack in your heart that can be undone. Don't know what love is till you've had mine. Coming through your door soon, I'll have you calling out for more. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Coming through your door soon, I'll have you calling out for more. Na 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 na. Na 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 na. Na 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 na.
Live. Yeah,
great.
That's great. I really enjoyed that. Let's talk about your rock and roll hobbies. And yes. We were talking about it just not so long ago. You fly helicopters, you fly fixed wing planes.
Fixed wing.
That's it. Nice that you've got rock and roll showbiz hobbies. How are they both going? Are you still keeping up with it?
Yeah, good. I did my qualifying cross country about 2 weeks ago. Which is
qualifying cross country.
Yeah, it's a 2.5-hour solo flight. You have to land at two separate airfields, totally solo, on your own. And you get marked by the air traffic control and they sign off and then you get back. And so now I can take my skills test.
So, Sophie, will you let Rich fly you anywhere? Or
I've actually been pretty cool about it.
We've already done it, actually, because I've got a friend who's a pilot and we flew down to Goodwood for the horse racing. Yes. A very cool way to turn up.
That's really cool.
Really?
And how's your helicopter? Well, I remember talking to you once about helicopters for 2 hours because you love it, don't you?
I love it so much, but it's hugely expensive. So, and I bought this old pub in the East End and I've turned it into a recording studio.
Oh. And I was excited there. I was like, what's up? Yeah. Right, Simon, we're going. And you turned it into a recording studio.
It's still got a bar in it.
No, it's still got a bar.
All right.
And you can still get drinks.
Me
so
and Mr. Rimmer.
Yeah,
down.
It's brilliant. You're welcome.
Just bash some tunes out as well. Yeah.
I can play the tambourine.
It's really good. But it's kind of taken over my kind of helicopter. But I'm going to go back to it. I just need to save up some money.
Now, Sophie, we can't have you on the show without... I don't know if you know we're doing this. Do you know we're doing this? We can't have the show, you on the show without having a clip of you from yesteryear, because that's basically what happens every time you go on a TV show. Because your mum used to put you on Blue Peter all the time, and so here's a clip of you on Blue Peter from when you were a kid with your mum.
To help demonstrate, which colour would you like?
The green.
And then you simply pop it over your head. You're not going to need it in here particularly, are you, with the studio lights up?
No.
It's nice if you sort of double it back around the outside like mine. What do you think of that?
It looks very nice.
You want to have a look in the mirror?
Mm,
you do.
Nice.
It goes with your pink cheeks. Mm. Let's put that round you. And of course, you can really play about with these. Let's twist that one around too. What do you think?
It looks very nice.
I said it looks nice about four times.
You're lying.
It's very nice. Well,
did you used to enjoy it when your mum would say, come on, come down on the show? Or did you think,
no. Yeah, no, it was quite seldom, actually. I mean, in 4 years she was doing the show, I think I was maybe it was on twice. Right. In fact, I have seen the snood clip since she left, but there was another one where I had a dress made for me out of bin bags, and I'd love to see that.
You should have found that one.
I tried to keep it. It was very noisy.
The schnooze, little did you know, you're going to influence all Premiership footballers years to come. that is all for now, but these guys are still going to hang around to cook with Simon and to look at some of the latest apps, greatest apps for your phones and tablets.